A diagnosis of cancer, diabetes, or multiple sclerosis is a lifelong diagnosis, and managing your ability to overcome and deal with these diseases, a lot of it is in your head. This morning we're joined by Danea Horn, local author of Chronic Resilience, 10 Sanity Saving Strategies for Women Coping with the Stress of Illness. This is fascinating because you, through personal experience, have found that a lot of it is in your head, kind of a head game.
Absolutely. So I was born with something called bacterial association. I had a number of surgeries and a very long healing journey when I was younger. Mm. As part of that diagnosis, I ended up with chronic kidney disease. I just have one kidney that had some malformations, and we're actually on the kidney transplant list and going to be doing a kidney transplant in a few months.
And so where did you get, how did you come up with chronic resilience? Tell us about what you were going through, especially in your, I mean, I know you're married, and yeah. Tell us about in your adult life what it was like and how it maybe impacted your marriage.
Well, the idea that something is chronic, it was the hardest thing to accept, because you always think, well, I just want to fix this. How, you know, it was sort of baffling to me that I couldn't make something go away. And so once you finally come to the realization that you need to accept that something is chronic, then you can come up with all kinds of strategies to cope with it and work your life around your illness so that illness doesn't take over your life.
What is the chronic resilience?
So chronic resilience, with chronic, you always think, well, I'm going to find that one magic pill that this is going to make this go away. But with resilience, when you realize that the human spirit can come back time and time again, and so it's the ability to take the bad news from the doctor or waiting for the scan and to be vulnerable with that and to really find where your power is.
And you found 10 sanity-saving ways to do that. Maybe share one or two of them with us.
Okay. So the first thing that we do is we concentrate on all the things that aren't in our control. So, you know, what if we're going to have a side effect from our medication, how our spouse is going to react to our illness. But there are a ton of things that are still in our control. You know, while we may have to change our diet or give up things that we used to enjoy, there are still a ton of things that we can do. We can get creative with recipes if we need to change our diet. We can focus on how to change our environment and our home to create a more relaxing space. We can focus on what goals and how to modify our goals that help us leave time so that we can rest and recuperate our health, but also still accomplish things.
And that sounds like those are some of the smaller things that you actually have control over. So does that give you a little bit of positive energy in all of that?
Absolutely, yeah. When we feel like we're contributing to our health, that completely changes our outlook. But when we feel like we're just sort of at the victim or at the mercy of what's going on in our body, then it plays games with your mind.
I'm curious, why did you just focus on women?
Well, guys don't get sick, of course.
But or at least not my husband.
Yeah, exactly. No, I wanted a book that felt like you were just chatting with a girlfriend. And so the voice that I write in is fairly feminine. There's nothing particularly girly in terms of the content. And if guys are up for a pink book, then I definitely think that they'll find a lot of great content in here. But I also think that there are a few things that women deal specifically with illness. Mm-hmm. You know, when we get sick, we still feel like we need to completely manage the family and the kids and the husband, and we want to step up to all those responsibilities. And we need to learn how to allow people in and how to allow people to help us, because we still can't do everything we used to.
I watched your YouTube video and you said it was just kind of like a light bulb and things really started to change for you and for also your family. So maybe a good book to, after you read for yourself, maybe let everyone else in your family.
Absolutely. I know when my husband read this, he goes, oh, chapter 6 totally helped me learn how to take care of you.
Oh, okay, we're out of time, but Chris Carr wrote, I highly recommend this groundbreaking book. She's from the New York Times bestselling author of Crazy Sexy Diet. So that's a pretty neat recommendation there. Danea, thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it. All right, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.